Arvind Srivastava, and today I will discuss about QSAR, that is Quantitative Structure Activity Relationship. This is a technique that is used to predict the activity of a molecule, and molecule may be synthesized, may be obtained from any natural source, or may be plant. So what we do, we take molecule and perform characterization, and then we perform animal activity. This is a normal but tedious process, and it is highly costly. It is very costly. And second method is without synthesis or after synthesis, without characterization or after characterization, we perform activity on animal models in vitro or in silico. In silico means applying some devices which use silicon, means computer, means IC containing devices. So these are in silico models. What we need for QSAR is parameters. This is called as descriptors in QSAR studies, also called as predictors because they predict the activity, or in common language these are called as physicochemical properties. Now I continue to physicochemical properties, and first property is lipophilicity, or you can say it hydrophobicity, and it can be measured by partition coefficient. First matter is a partition coefficient. So why lipophilicity is so important? We must understand why it is so important. So first of all, lipophilicity is important for membrane permeation. Because any drug which has to penetrate membrane must have some properties of must have some affinity with membrane. And second one is solubility. Solubility, or simply we can say that aqueous solubility, must be soluble in water. So membrane permeation and solubility, these two parameters are very important for a drug. So for measurement of partition coefficient, what we do, we just measure partition coefficient equals to concentration of drug in organic phase over concentration of drug in aqueous phase. This is a ratio. Partition coefficient is a ratio. Concentration of drug in organic phase upon concentration of drug in aqueous phase. Hence was a scientist who replaced all organic solvents with octanol. And octanol was used as organic phase for the determination of this partition coefficient. Because what happened with different solvents, suppose someone was using ethanol, someone was using methanol, chloroform, and the number of variation, there was a lot of variation found in these partition coefficient estimation. And when this was standardized by octanol, so all these variations were rectified. So hence rectified all these variations by using octanol, and hence the equation changes and goes to partition coefficient equals to concentration of drug in octanol upon concentration of drug in water. After discussion of partition coefficient, Second, lipophilic hydrophilic parameter, that is hydrophobic parameter, that is chromatographic parameters. Chromatographic parameters are obtained after chromatographic analysis using a stationary phase and a mobile phase. But in QSAR studies, these parameters are of least importance, but partition coefficient parameters are more relevant in QSAR models. Sizability depends upon three parameters. First is molar volume, second molar refractivity, and third is paracut. All these are interrelated, they have deep relation. Suppose we take formula of molar volume is molecular weight upon density. So molar refractivity is molar volume into refractive index, and paracur value, as we know, is molar volume into gamma, that is surface tension raised to power 1/4. So this is the relation between these three. And any property, suppose molar volume, refractive index, or gamma, surface tension, if we know any of the property, we can formulate, we can keep that value in formula, and we can estimate the physicochemical parameter for our QSAR model. Third, most important property, that is electronic parameters. And in electronic parameters, first parameter, that is Hammett substitution constant. Hammett substitution constant is a measure of electron withdrawing or electron donating power of a substituent of a group. So how this electron withdrawing group in benzoic acid, what happens? On ionization, the equilibrium will be shifted towards the right hand side, and less conjugation, less combination of these ions will take place, and reformation of benzoic acid with electron withdrawing group is less. While when we add electron donating group in this benzoic acid, what we find that the equilibrium will shift towards left hand side. If we place this value in this equation, the equilibrium constant KH, what we'll find, delta value will be positive in first case and negative in another case. So delta positive for electron withdrawing group, and delta will be negative for electron donating group. So this, by using benzoic acid and its salt, we can calculate, we can estimate the Hammett substitution constant small sigma. Hammett substitution constant, that is most important parameter that I have told you earlier. Second parameter is field and resonance parameters, based on the resonance ability of a molecule. Some molecules have resonating structures and some molecules do not have resonating structures, and some field effects are also there. So these are also important. This they have some impact in Hammett substitution constant also, because if we place benzoic acid in ortho position and in para position, so in some position there is resonance effect, but I am not going to describe all these because it is a very lengthy topic. So field and resonance parameters are they incorporate with Hammett substitution constant also. Third one is parameters from spectroscopy. A lot of parameters are obtained from spectroscopic analysis. Spectroscopic analysis like IR, NMR, mass spectroscopy, and other type of LC-MS, GC-MS data, where chromatographics are also incorporated with spectroscopy. So these data are very important, and they impart their effect in as a physicochemical parameter for QSAR. Third one is dipole moment. Dipole moment. Suppose we take example of HCl molecule, H is positive and Cl is highly negative, and when they are placed in a capacitor, so they rotate themselves, and you know better how dipole moment is calculated or estimated. am not going to calculate or estimate the dipole moment right now, but dipole moment of any substance has a great role as a physicochemical parameter in QSAR studies. Next is quantum chemical parameters. Quantum chemical parameters are the elementary parameters which we study in chemistry, like electronegativity, the power to attract an electron by an atom, the power of an atom to attract an electron in electronegativity. Second is chemical potential, you know, better the electrochemical series. Next is electrophilicity. Electrophilicity, that is electron loving nature, or you can say electropositivity. These are some parameters which incorporate as electronic parameters, as a physicochemical parameters